We start tonight to enter into the text that some of you have seen, but many of you don't, about, well, the text itself is named the Bodhisattva Paryavatara, Jamshup Senpe Chopala Jupa in Tibetan, which means the entrance or the walking on the Bodhisattva path.
Nocoj se bomo začeli ukvarjati z besedilom, ki ga nekateri od vas že poznate, številni pa ne. Temu besedilu je naslov Bodhisattva Paryavatara, kar pomeni vstop ali hoja po poti Bodhisattva.
It's a text which has been written by Arya Shantideva and which is dedicated to the motivation of the Bodhisattva throughout the whole path, from the first moment of understanding what Bodhicitta is till the realization of enlightenment.
To besedilo je napisal Arya Shantideva, posvečeno pa je motivaciji bodhisattve na celi poti, od prvega razumevanja, kaj je bodhicitta, do realizacije razsvetljenja.
So bodhicitta we have seen last time already in a sense that it is the motivation generated by practitioner entering on the Mahayana path, the motivation which enables one to dedicate fully his or her practice, or the whole life actually, for the sake of all other sentient beings.
Bodhicitto smo si ogledali že prejšnjič, in sicer kot motivacijo, ki jo oblikuje praktikant, ko vstopi na pot Mahajane. To je motivacija, ki posamezniku omogoči, da popolnoma posreti svojo prakso, pravzaprav celo svoje življenje za dobrobit drugih čutečih, vseh drugih čutečih biti.
It's the core motivation actually for our practice. It's a personal, an inner, deep personal dedication for the sake of the others.
To je osrednja motivacija, glavna motivacija za našo prakso. Gre za osebno, notranjo, globoko osebno predanost dobrobiti drugim.
As often I refer to the motivation being at the root of our existence, because it is on the basis of what we decide as being our motivation, that we will engage or not engage in certain action, in certain practices, in certain developments within our daily life as well as in our spiritual progression, spiritual path.
Pogosto poudarjam, da je motivacija sam temelj našega obstoja, ker na osnovi tega, kaj se izberemo za svojo motivacijo, se bomo lotili ali pa ne določenih praks, določenega razvoja v svojem vsakdanjem življenju in na duhovni poti.
If our motivation is not clear, then our life might not be clear as well, because we might not know exactly in which direction we should act, we should direct our steps. So it is very important to know where we want to go, to know which kind of energy we are willing to devote, to engage for the practice or for the spiritual development and for helping the others.
Če naša motivacija ni jasna, potem tudi naše življenje ni jasno, ker mogoče ne vemo točno, v katero smer bi delovali, v katero smer bi krenili. Zato je zelo pomembno, da vemo, kam želimo iti, s kakšno energijo želimo vložiti v prakso, v duhovni razvoj in v pomoč drugim.
We can see how beneficial it is already to help on a very conventional level, to give some food to people who are hungry, to give some support or some advice to people who are in trouble or in difficulties. This is already great, and this is already a large accumulation of merits, of positive karma that can be dedicated for our spiritual path. But in comparison with one moment of bodhicitta, this dedication of one's all existence for helping the others, then there is a big difference. It is incomparable in terms of merit accumulation.
Že na v vsakdanjem življenju, na konvencionalni ravni, lahko vidimo, kako koristno je pomagati drugim, naprimer nahraniti lačnega, ali nuditi podporo ali nasvet nekomu, ki je v težavah. S tem si že ustvarimo zelo veliko pozitivne karme, ki jo lahko potem posvetimo za svojo duhovno pot. Toda, če to primerjamo z enim samim trenutkom bodičite, se pravi z posvetitvijo našega vsega življenja za druge, lahko vidimo, da je tu velika, ogromna razlika in da z bodičito ustvarimo veliko več zaslug.
And it is definitely good to hear again and again about bodhicitta, because this is not something that we often think about or that we often place a lot of effort. We know what bodhicitta is and we have the wish to develop bodhicitta, but we tend to be caught by our usual habits, our usual patterns of existence, and these kind of patterns tend to overwhelm our good motivation.
Zato je nedvomno dobro, da vedno znova slišimo, poslušamo učenje o bodičiti, ker o tem ne razmišljamo pogosto, pa tudi veliko truda ne vlagamo v to. Vemo, kaj je bodičita in želimo si jo razviti, da vedno znova se ujamemo v svoje običajne vzorce in navade, ki zasenčijo našo motivacijo.
So the more we think about, the more we talk about, the more we remind ourselves about this awakening mind, this mind seeking awakening to benefit all sentient beings. And the more it sinks within our mind, and the more we are acting from thoughts, speech and action according to that motivation, according to that type of bodhisattva aspirant motivation.